A nice sack. He a bitch, he a fold under pressure. I can tell from his posture, man, he ain't really like that. Mama told me I don't care if you scared. Go in for the kill. If they try, you better fight back. We'll beat his ass if he try to throw the folks up. What's all that shit you was saying like you was so tough? They gon' have to carry your mans if he approach us. Creeping in that glizzy of blam when we get close.
Hey, this is Kirk.
And this is Byrd. It's the Kirk and Byrd Show. We are pleased to have clearly our most popular guest. He keeps winning, so we got to bring him back. Coach Mickey Thompson of Stonebridge High School football team. Coach, thank you for joining us again.
Thanks for being here. I like seeing you guys.
Yeah, thanks, man.
How'd you like that music, Coach?
I didn't, but that's okay.
Do you know who it is?
No.
We just found out from the students. It's Polo G. So your kids will like it. So if you win next weekend, which we know you're going to, we want you to dance in the locker room to some Polo G. So spread the word. You got to bust a move to some Polo G.
Look at, like Frank Beamer.
Hey, they played Soldier Boy at the game, and I was thinking about you doing the Soldier Boy. But, hey, congratulations. You know, another state final. I think it's your 16th, and you beat a great football team. You beat a great football team. It was a fun game. How's it feel? You're going back to the state finals. I got ODU is my backdrop, and we talked about this.
Well, I mean, we're pretty excited. I mean, we played Maury, 2 years ago, and first quarter was pretty hard on us. We went down 21-0, 28-0 early, and we couldn't get back in it. So get another shot, get another opportunity. That's all you can ask for.
Yep. Okay.
Yeah, Coach, one of the things I think we talked about before, but I love the way you put your schedule together this year. Can you talk about your schedule and how it might have prepared you? I mean, you played at some Division VI, really good Division IV team, like a broad run. But tell us a little bit about that schedule and how you guys think, what you're thinking about when you put it together.
Well, honestly, I used to think, you know, you need to look at the schedule and try to figure out, you know, when you needed breaks and when you didn't. And then over the years, I just got to the point where the best teams, any team we can find, the best team we can find is going to be the best situation for us. Because, you know, there's just so many ups and downs on high school teams. And you just need to keep, if you're playing good people, I think people want to play for you. So yep, they'll come, they want to play in those games. They don't want to play in the games that are, 60-0. Yeah. You can help it. But sometimes you can't get games, so it just depends on who's willing to play.
I don't think Martinsburg, that they've been playing some Virginia teams, you know. So why don't we talk about Highland Springs? I mean, it was a great game. I was impressed with them. I thought they were coached well. They were big up front. Great quarterback. He's a sophomore. That kid should be going places. And really good, and they're physical. And I like that back they had, who was pretty bruising. And you guys hung in there and executed and won the game. Just give me your thoughts on, because it was a game that had some ebb and flow.
Right.
Your thoughts on, your kids were very resilient, you know. But let's get your overview for the fans out there.
Well, I thought we played well in all three phases. All three phases made, you know, had an impact. And I think the game really came down to we struggled to stop them, slow them down, and they struggled to stop us. So it was, you know, one of those things where defensively we had a fight because we made a lot of stops, but we gave up a lot of first downs, and that's okay, but then you have less offensive snaps. So it's a give and take, but you know, we were struggling getting three and out, getting on them. They were struggling stopping us. And, you know, it was one of those things where you come down to one mistake or one call or one, you know, and I know there's a lot of calls in the game they're upset about, but there's a lot of calls in the game we're upset about. We were upset about too. So,
yeah,
you know, and it's one of those things where I just think we have so much respect for what they do and the way they coach, because you really – you're not going to ever get a trick play on them, anything like that. They're just going to be sound. They're going to be where they're supposed to be. And then you just got to win. And I like playing games like that where it's not a question of you're not going to out-scheme them. I don't feel like they're going to out-scheme us. And it's just a matter of executing. So,
And I thought the game was extremely well played. And I could tell the coaching was just off the chart. You guys, I mean, you're two multiple-time state championship coaches, but your play, I mean, the offense you're running, Mickey, like that shows the amount of detail that you guys, which you have to perfect and do well, but that also shows me your kids are buying in and they're learning and they're practicing and they're getting those things down. I was just impressed by, you know, I told Kirk, I said, this game is going to come down to who has the ball last. You know, like, I mean, even just the way the first half ended, when you guys scored, and I think it's just a little over a minute to go, and then they come right down and score. That game was just exciting. And so, you know, I know when you're on the sideline, it's not necessarily the same way we feel about it. But Coach, tell me, do you ever get? I can't do it now, but when you look back, do you go? How do you look at that film? What are you gonna? You know, are you? Do you just find the things that the kids need to work on? Are you able to praise them at this point and say, oh, we did this well, or just what?
We just preach that, you know, it's one thing, it's one call, it's one play that's going to be the difference in these games. And, you know, we made three or four mistakes that, you know, they could have cost us the game, but then they made three or four mistakes. So we, you know, it counteracted it, but we can take those three or four mistakes and say, look what happens if we don't make those mistakes.
Yeah,
and look what it could have cost us, you know. So, and if we get one less mistake next week, then maybe that's enough, or maybe that's still too many. I don't know, but we're just trying to minimize coach impact. That's one. Really, you don't want to minimize your impact on the game. Let the kids decide it. You know, I was a little more. I wasn't quite as cautious as I thought I would be in that game because we did have some fourth down conversions, but you know, you got to be careful because you make a call like that and it doesn't go well, then who's responsible? I mean, because they're so evenly matched that can be a difference maker.
Yeah, absolutely. I there was a fourth down that you went for in the fourth quarter. I was like, man, whew, great call though.
as long as we get it.
Like, yeah. No. Yes.
Wanted to ask you, on the fade to number 13, do you see that coming? The one-handed catch. Because I called it. Remember, Rusty? I said they're going to throw a fade to number 13.
Yeah. I was worried about that because we had the unsportsmanlike it when we scored, so they got field position right away and returned the kick.
Yep.
And you were saying there was a minute left. There's 27 seconds left. And we kick off, and they score. Yeah, that's crazy.
Yeah,
because they got the kick return, and then they had, you know, still had 20 seconds left. Mm-hmm. And yeah, I was worried about that because, you know, they had size on the outside, and I knew it could be a problem. So
one other thing, Rusty, and I'll let you chime in is, I noticed every time they went trips, whether it was right or left, they never went to that side. I mean, obviously, you noticed that. Maybe I'm wrong or missed it, but they never went when they had trips right or trips left, they ran the ball in the other direction. And I thought sooner or later, they're going to go to the trip side. Is that something you saw, you and Zach?
No, I mean, if they did, they didn't tell me.
Okay. I just,
Billy Rice runs our defense, him and Zach, and it's, they do a great job, and I'm, you know, I'm there, but I'm a cheerleader for those two, is, you know, and you know, so maybe there's something to it. I don't know, but
right,
you know, we didn't have that discussion.
Okay.
You know, one of the things I think this venue this weekend, I'm excited for them to be playing at Old Dominion Stadium, the remodeled stadium. I grew up in Hampton Roads, and I remember that stadium back because Norfolk State played there before ODU even had a football team again. But then I was excited when ODU got football. But I was there in 2019 for a game, and it is just, I think, the perfect facility. I've seen you guys play at UVA, which is maybe a little too big. And I saw you at Hampton University, and I was packed in there when you guys played there a couple of times. So I think I'm really excited to go home to such a great venue for high school football. Have you been there before, Coach?
You mean Maury High School?
No, I'm talking about Old Dominion.
Well, might as well be. They're right next to each other, right?
Oh, yeah, you're right.
Very close.
Yeah.
Yeah, big, right. Big travel for them for this. Yep.
Good point, Coach.
I drove by last year on the way home. We I don't know how we got rerouted, but we were over by ODU Stadium.
Right. Yeah.
Yeah. So. You'll really like it. It's great. I mean, I think, and you guys played the second game, right?
Yeah, the 4:30.
You finished under the lights, and it's just really beautiful.
Yeah. Yeah. So, Coach, when are you going down?
Saturday.
Saturday morning? Okay. Yeah. And you said you're coming back?
Oh, yeah.
Okay. All right. Great. Now, how's your health? Jacob, we saw him going through by the way, he was unbelievable. I'm so impressed with him. He's got so much poise when he rolls out. How's he doing with the?
He's doing well.
Yeah.
No issues there.
Right.
We got some guys with some bumps and bruises, but I think coming out, unless there's something Monday I don't know about, it looks like we got out relatively free of any kind of injury.
Yeah. Because I talked to Micah Smith afterwards.
And he had a brace that – something with the brace, and the doc said he should be fine. I mean, you just never know. Monday shows up, and that's the day where you go, wow, didn't know this was coming. But
yeah. He's really developed as a player. He's looking like a beast out there because I talked to him when you played Liberty, and we talked about how much he played last year. And very, very, very good physical player. Rusty, let's transition to Maury because we know we've talked to Coach McCain. We know a little bit about that program. Segue us to Maury. And we know, Coach, you can only say so much, but we know you face a big challenge. Rusty, we've talked to Larry Rabama about Maury. We've talked to Coach DeRee McCain. Let's ask Mickey, Coach Thompson, about, you know, the challenge that they face from a team that beat a very good Green Run Stallions team, 35-7 on Saturday. Oh, I was going to transition. So, Coach, you know, you've got Maury is a formidable opponent, but you just beat a very, very good team. So you've got two in a row. You're facing a great team, great quarterback. What do you need to do besides what you're already doing? Your kids are buying in. You're executing. It's going to come down to a number of mistakes. But, again, this is a different team. What are your thoughts?
I really don't have them right now. I haven't seen enough film, to be perfectly honest. The film we got is pretty bad, so it takes a while to get through. And I don't know. I haven't really – tomorrow's a big day for us to really start trying to put things together.
Break it down.
You know, I don't know a whole lot about it. We watched some of their film, but they haven't played that many games. So,
right.
Yeah.
In comparison to everybody else.
They've missed games because of COVID. Yeah. And so I would like to just touch on one point earlier. I know you guys played Madison. So, when I go back to the tough schedule you've had, you beat Freedom. They were in the regional championship. Madison won their state semi, and they're going to be playing Oscar Smith. Have you seen any of Oscar Smith this year?
No.
To be able to comment on them? Okay, I didn't think so. Were you all ever, over all these years, were you ever in the same division or have you played Oscar Smith?
Nope.
Okay.
They've always been six.
Okay. All right. Now, what
so we beat the Division VI team, Madison, who's playing for a state title. And then we beat Broad Run, who's playing for the Division IV state title.
Right. Yep. That's right. Wow. You also, did you guys beat Centerville?
Yeah.
Did you? Yeah. Wow. That schedule, again, that is a tough schedule, man, I will tell you. The other thing I wanted to ask you about is you've played Maury before. They're a newer program with their coach. but you've had experience. What was your first state championship game? Was it what year was that, and who were you coaching for, and who did you coach against?
The first one that I coached in?
Mm-hmm. As the head coach.
That was in 99 with Parkview.
Okay.
Oh, right. Okay.
Right. It was one of Willis White's last games at Salem.
Mm-hmm. Great okay. program. Great program.
Yeah. I remember going to one of your – my first time watching you guys play was a state championship against Potomac. That I don't. Was that 07?
That's 07, yeah.
Yeah, okay. Yeah, that was a really good game too. So, yeah, and that's what's behind you—the 07 state championship.
Yep, it is.
That's a great picture. Yeah.
Beat and you know, I bring this up, but it is the truth. You beat one of the best Phoebus teams in the history of Phoebus. That was a loaded team. So, I mean, kudos. But I'd be remiss if we didn't. I want to bring up a couple things. Now I picked Stone Bridge to beat Highland Springs, but Mr. Byrd picked against you.
He's that guy. You can tell.
Mickey, I said, hey, look.
Hey.
I said, at one point, if you look, I think I changed my pick after everybody else said Stonebridge. I just had to kind of
change your pick.
But look, I was almost right.
Look, yeah, you were almost right.
Look, when we go to the beach with them this summer, you're sleeping outside in the car, and I'm getting one of those.
Man, look, I didn't know, but somebody. Okay, so look, I'm better than Jay. Jay on our show, he picked Battlefield to beat Oscar Spells. Now, I didn't fall for that one. I did not fall for that.
All right, so who you got, Maury or Stonebridge?
Thank you, MC. That's what I was gonna say. Who you got?
I've got Stonebridge. That's right.
All right. Next time you have one of those guys on, I want to hear you say it.
Okay. I got to stick with it because you were here. You said it first. But I will say this. I have two nieces that go to – my brother lives in Arizona. I have two nieces that go to Maury, and my younger nephew, he's going to be a football star there in like 2 years. And my niece has been the defending state tennis champion since the ninth grade, and she just signed with ODU. So when they hear this, I'm sorry, y'all. I love Maury, but Coach Thompson, I've seen you guys, so let's go Stonebridge. Sorry, Maya.
I'm going on the record. Stonebridge, very close game. I don't think it's, I think it's going to be a razor sharp game. And by the way, like I said, Coach McCain is a class guy. He's not young, but, you know, he's a younger guy. He's in his 30s. He runs a really good program, really respectful kids. And we're going to be down there, and we're especially looking forward to seeing both teams play. But I just want to tell you this. There's a lot of chatter out there, and I want you and I want your kids to hear this. A lot of guys down the 757 are – they haven't even seen you play. And they're like, well, Maury's going to take care of them. They're going to have a long bus ride home. And, you know, based on this, and they're not used to athletic teams. I'm like, listen, have you seen them play? Have you seen Stonebridge play? No. So little bulletin board. Go ahead, Rusty. Little bulletin board.
Hey, here. Look right here. I got Norfolk State. I got Bethel. My brother's a professor here. I toted the rock for Bethel back in the day. I got my Hall of Fame helmet here. Look, Coach. We take a lot of pride in our football down there, right? Okay, right. So like that's what it is. So this is going to be on their the Hampton Roads High School football Facebook page. So much chatter, but they do love football. They're proud, and I understand. I totally understand. But I will tell you, one of the closest that I've seen to any of the love down there is when I go to Stonebridge football games. Your crowd, they know football, they're cheering at the right stuff, and they bring it. Like, I'm telling you, I go to a lot of high school football games, and there, you guys don't just pack it in the playoffs. You know, I went to the Freedom game, and the environment, it reminds me of being at home when I was playing, you know, the Hampton Bethel game in the early 80s, and I was playing, you know, in standing room only against the Crabbers. And I feel that way when I'm going to your game. So, but we just take a lot of pride in football. So, but hey, this is going to be on the site. 757 people. Yes, you did hear me pick Stonebridge, but I we got a lot of respect for all our hometown squads. I'll say this. I think Phoebus, that's going to be a tough one, and Oscar Smith, they should win. But Madison, listen to me, guys. Madison is solid. I've seen them. I saw them play Westfield. I've seen them against South Lakes. Do not sleep on Madison. I'm telling you. They played Mickey tough. So Coach Thompson tough. So we'll see.
Well, I just wanted, before we close out, you know, honestly, to talk to your kids. And I encourage that, you know, they listen to this because they're going to get you to dance to Polo G, who groomed himself in the Chicago penal system before he became a rapper. There, you know, I want your kids to go down there and know that there is a certain superiority complex down there. Okay, you're coming down to the 757 and you guys are Northern Virginia and blah, 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 blah. And I used to talk that way back in the 90s, by the way. It's not that way anymore. So, you know, you're playing a class program, a very good team. And we are looking forward to watching you raise that cup on Saturday and have a great bus ride back home. We had a blast in the stands. We're looking forward to, I don't know what the weather's going to be, but we'll be ready. And tell your kids, pulling for them. Let's get that third state championship and keep rolling.
Thanks, Coach. I appreciate it, man. Hey, we can always edit this, right? If something goes wrong, this is live, like radio. Well,
he never did say.
It's a podcast, bro. We can you can see my lips ghost, Maury. I picked Maury.
Before we close out, our podcast is the Kirk and Byrd Show. We'll have it overlaid. We want to ask everybody to subscribe to it. So if you're subscribed, when this comes out tomorrow, we process the video, they'll get an alert. And we put the stuff on the screen, and that's growing. And we ask your kids. The kids are all big with Twitter. The football coaches are on there, the college coaches. We're at the Kirk and Byrd, D-Y-R-D. And then we've also got everything on audio with all of the prominent podcast platforms. So, Coach, good luck. We will be down there and looking for a great day and seeing the Stonebridge Bulldogs win their third state championship. And we're not flipping back to Maury. So
I'm just looking for a good game. I had to make a prediction.
Oh, it's going to be a good game.
He is backing down.
No, that's no, crazy. Look.
No. I'll go on the record and say this, Coach.
I love both programs. But if I had to say, based on my analysis, I think you guys will win the game based on your schedule and what I've seen. So, right.
But nobody's blowing anybody out in this game. And, Coach, if you
no. want to come on now,
put that as bulletin board, then let's be real. You're Coach, playing a great football team.
If I'm on another, if we do a show with the Maury coach and I change my prediction, it's because Kirk made me do it. No, go ahead. Seriously, I got you, Coach, and I'm pulling for you for real. You've been a class.
I hope you get some sleep tonight because you're gonna have to think about this all night.
Up, bro. They're gonna light me up.
Oh. We're getting ready to tape another segment.
I wouldn't be able to say, I told you.
Now, we're getting ready to tape another segment about some back and forth with Battlefield and Oscar Smith. So, but we'll look to see you on Saturday. Best of luck. Hope you have a great week of practice. Break down that film. And we're looking for the kids to execute and bring home another state championship to Ashburn. All right, Coach?
All right, buddy. Thank you.
All right, buddy. God bless.
See y'all.